Hello students, today in this video we are going to study the chapter The Little Girl of our book Beehive. The title of the story refers to the main character that we will come across, the little girl named Kezia. The theme of the story is the relationship between children and their parents, and the writer Catherine Mansfield wants to tell us that children share a very important bond of love with their parents. Although when children are small, when they are young, they do not feel that their parents love them because their parents are strict and many actions of the parents seems unjustified. But as children grow up, they realize that all the acts done by their parents were beneficial for them. The parents were concerned for them, and beneath the strictness lies a heart full of love for the children. And this bond of love between parents and their children has been highlighted through this story. To the little girl, he was a figure to be feared and avoided. स्टोरी में ये बताया गया है कि जो केजिया है, द लिटिल गर्ल, उसके जो पिताजी हैं, फादर, वो अब क्या है उसके लिए? अ फिगर ऑफ फियर, डरने वाली चीज़ है उसके लिए, और वो इसलिए क्या करती है? उनसे अवॉइड भी करती है, दूर रहने की कोशिश करती है. सो एवरी मॉर्निंग Before going to work, Kezia's father would visit her in her room and give her a casual kiss. And in reply, Kezia would say, "Goodbye, father." So this action of Kezia's father shows his love for Kezia. Office जाने से पहले उसके पापा उससे मिल के जाते हैं. ये show करता है कि उसके पापा उससे क्या करते हैं? बहुत प्यार करते हैं. And over there was a glad sense of relief when she heard the noise of the carriages going fainter and fainter down the long road. और फिर जब कैरियर, जिससे उसके पिताजी गाड़ी से या जो भी है उससे जब चले जाते हैं, उसकी आवाज़ जब धीरे धीरे कम सुनाई देने लगती है, तो उसके लिए a sense of relief होता है, काफ़ी वो रिलैक्स महसूस करती है कि now the father has gone. In the evening when Kezia's father would return home, she would hear his loud voice, and this loud voice again made her afraid of him. शाम को जब वो वापस आते हैं, उनकी आवाज़ सुन के फिर से वो क्या होती है? डरने लगती है. So when Kezia's father returned home, he would start ordering all different things. He would order that tea be served to him in the drawing room. He wanted the newspaper. He would ask his mother to go and see if the newspaper was there outside the house, and he would ask her to get him his slippers also. Kezia's mother would call out to her and ask her to remove her father's boot. In order to make her obey, she would say that if she was a good girl, then surely she would obey her command. So again we see Kezia fear for her father. That is why she would come down the stairs quietly and unwillingly, because she did not want to face her father. She feared him. Now think of Kezia's father sitting in the room on a sofa, wearing his spectacles, and he is looking at Kezia over the spectacles, and now the way he looked at her terrified her. She was horrified because maybe it seemed to her that he was staring at her. Kezia was reluctant in her work. She was slow in her motion, and so her father would tell her to hurry up and remove his boots and keep them out of the room. And then he would ask her if she had been a good girl that day. Kezia के पिताजी उसको पूछते हैं कि वो क्या उसने पूरे दिन एक अच्छी लड़की की तरह स्पेंड किया है, और वो काम क्या करती है, धीरे धीरे करती है, रेलुकेंट मतलब उसको करने की इच्छा नहीं है, डर रही है, तो उस काम जो है वो धीरे करती है, इसलिए उसके फादर उसको क्या करते हैं, जल्दी जल्दी करने के लिए कहते हैं। एंड केजिया रिप्लाइड दैट सी डिडंट नो, वो बताती है कि उसको नहीं मालूम कि वो पूरे दिन अच्छी लड़की बन के रही या नहीं। सो वाई वॉज सी स्टैमरिंग, बिकॉज सी वॉज नॉट कॉन्फिडेंट। अ पर्सन इज नॉट कॉन्फिडेंट वेन ही हैज़ एनी फीलिंग ऑफ फियर। स्टैमरिंग हकला रही है डरने की वजह से, ठीक है ना। सो हर केजियाज फादर इज कॉपिंग हर एंड ही ऑल्सो स्टैमर्स लाइक सी डिड। He says to her that if she stuttered like that, then her mother would have to take her to the doctor for a checkup. उसके पापा भी उसी की तरह stammer करके बोलते हैं कि अगर वो इस तरह से stammer करेगी, हकलाएगी, तो उसकी मम्मी को उसे किसे दिखाना होगा, डॉक्टर को। Kezia never stammered while talking to other people. यहाँ ये पता चलता है कि वो स्टैमरिंग हकलाना सिर्फ वो पापा को देख के डरने की वजह से होता है, किसी और से बात करते समय वो बिल्कुल भी स्टैमर नहीं करती है। इट वॉज ओनली वेन सी टॉक टू हर फादर दैट सी लैक कॉन्फिडेंस एंड दैट इज वाई सी ट्राइड वेरी हार्ड टू स्पीक प्रॉपरली एंड सी स्टैमर्ड। नाउ केजियाज फादर लुक्स एट हर, ही फील्स दैट समथिंग इज रॉन्ग विथ हर एंड ही आस्क्ड हर why she is so unhappy, and then he tells the mother that she would tease Kezia to behave in a better way and she should not appear as if she is so unhappy that she is about to end her life. So he wants to say that Kezia seems to be so unhappy with her life that she did not want to live any longer. He hands her his teacup and asks her to place it back on the table. Now Kezia feels that her father is very big. She feels that her father was so big. He was just like a giant. And the writer says that Kezia felt that his hand and his neck and his mouth were also huge, especially when he yawned. It seemed as if he was a huge monster. And whenever Kezia thought about her father, she felt that she was thinking about a giant. Every Sunday during the afternoon, Kezia's grandmother sent her downstairs to the drawing room in order to spend time with her parents. So Kezia was supposed to behave in a nice and decent way in front of her parents, and they had a formal get together. Every Sunday afternoon, when she went to her parents to meet them in the drawing room and have a nice talk with them, they were busy doing their own things. Her mother was busy reading and her father was busy sleeping and snoring. So Kezia had this image of her parents in her mind. They did not talk with her. They did not spend time with her. On the other hand, they were busy doing their own things. So all the while Kezia's father was asleep, she would just sit on a stool and watch him carefully till the time he would wake up and stretch his body and then would ask the time and look at her. Kezia's father would compare Kezia to a little brown owl. He would say that Kezia was staring at him just like an owl does. Now Kezia was not well. She had a cold, so she was supposed to stay at home. फीवर है उसको, सर्दी है, एंड इसलिए उसे घर पे रहना है। सो हर ग्रैंडमदर सजेस्टेड दैट एज सी वॉज एट होम एंड हर फादर्स बर्थडे वॉज अप्रोचिंग, सी कुड मेक अ बर्थडे गिफ्ट फॉर हिम। सी आस्क्ड केजिया टू मेक अ पिन कुशन फॉर हिम and she also gave her a yellow colored fabric of silk to make the cushion. Kezia put in lot of effort to make the birthday gift. She used double cotton. Double cotton से मतलब यहाँ thread से है, okay? And she stitched three sides of the cushion. Now Kezia had prepared the bag, shape of the cushion. She had to stitch the fourth side, and before that, she had to fill the cushion with something, and she did not know what to fill the cushion with. Cushion में बैग तो बन गया, अब उसमें कुछ भरना है एंड देन फोर्थ साइड से सिलना है, तो उसमें क्या भरना है उसको समझ में नहीं आ रहा है. सो केजिया वॉज कन्फ्यूज्ड दैट वॉट सूट सी यूज टू फिल द कुशन विथ. एज हर ग्रैंड मदर वॉज आउट इन द गार्डन एंड सी वॉज जस्ट लुकिंग फॉर समथिंग सी रीच्ड हर मदर्स बेडरूम. सी वॉज लुकिंग फॉर बिट्स ऑफ पेपर और क्लोथ to stuff in to the cushion. Kezia is a small little girl. She is very young. Now what she do? On the bed table, she found a heap of sheet of paper. So she just gathered all the sheets, then tore them and stuffed those pieces of paper into the cushion. And then she stitched the fourth side of the cushion and she had prepared a birthday gift for her father. So many of you can relate to Kezia's act. Many children do such things unknowingly. They do not intend to create any mischief or harm anyone, but they end up doing it. Now Kezia has torn some important paper. आपको भी मालूम है छोटे बच्चे गलती से नहीं मीन्स जानबूझ के नहीं करते एंड अननोइंगली उनसे ऐसा कुछ हो जाता है एंड दैट कॉजेज सम प्रॉब्लम इन द हाउस. नाउ देयर वाज लॉट ऑफ शाउटिंग इन द हाउस बिकॉज केजियाज फादर हैड प्रिपेयर्ड अ स्पीच फॉर द पोर्ट अथॉरिटी अ पर्टिकुलर मीटिंग और समथिंग एंड ही वाज अनेबल टू फाइंड इट. नाउ वी ऑल नो वेयर द स्पीच हैज गॉन. It has been torn into tiny pieces and Kezia has stuffed it into the cushion. Now the family searched everywhere. They asked the servants, but no one knew where the sheets of paper had gone. And finally, the mother reached the Kezia's room. Now here we get to see that Kezia is an innocent girl. She did not intend to harm anyone. She was just preparing her birthday gift. And so very truly, she tells her mother that she found some pieces of paper and as she needed them to stuff into the cushion, so she tore them and prepared her surprise gift. That is a birthday gift that she had prepared for her father. Unknowingly, Kezia had done a great disaster. Now Kezia's mother is so furious when she comes to know that Kezia has torn the speech that her father is looking for, and so she orders Kezia to come down into the dining room at that very moment. मम्मी को जब ये बात पता चली कि केजिया ने उन पेपरों को क्या किया है टॉर्न कर दिया फाड़ दिया है एंड पुट दैट स्टफ इन द कुशन वो उसको नीचे आने के लिए ऑर्डर करती हैं. नाउ केजियाज फादर इज फुल ऑफ टेंशन एज हिज इम्पोर्टेंट डॉक्यूमेंट्स हैज बीन लॉस्ट. केजिया हैज टॉर्न इट इन टू पीसेज. नाउ केजिया विल बी स्कोल्डेड फॉर द मिसचीफ दैट सी हैज डन. नाउ केजियाज फादर इज रेफरिंग द कुशन एज अ डैम्ड थिंग बिकॉज he is angry at the cushion because Kezia has torn his important documents to prepare it. Now he is very angry with Kezia and he stared at her and asked her if she had torn the papers. Kezia was so scared that she was again stammering, and then Kezia's father ordered mother to go and bring that cushion downstairs and asked her to put Kezia to bed at that very moment. Kezia wanted to justify her action as she was innocent. She did not mean to harm her father. She was just preparing a surprise birthday gift for him. Kezia was very sad. She had been happy that she had prepared a surprise for her father and he would like it. But on the other hand, she had accidentally committed a disaster. Now, he is about to punish Kezia for the wrong act she has done. Now, Kezia's father told her that he would beat her with a ruler. Kezia was so scared that she tried to hide under the seats. Now we come to know that why Kezia's father was being strict with her. Why was he punishing her? Because he wanted Kezia to know this thing once for all, that she should not touch that thing that does not belong to her. He wanted to teach her this thing so that it benefited in her future life. Right now, she was a small child. She did not know what was important and what was not important. That is why unknowingly she has torn the important document of her father. And so he was punishing her. He did not want to harm Kezia, but he wanted that Kezia should know that in future she should not touch anything that does not belong to her. Kezia tried to explain her position. She said that she had been preparing a birthday gift for her father and had to stuff it with something. She just tore the paper to stuff them into the cushion. She was trying to explain to him that she was just preparing a birthday gift for him. She wanted to give him a surprise. She did not want to tear his important documents, but Kezia's father did not listen to her excuses. Kezia's father hit the palms of her hand with a ruler. Now Kezia was so afraid she had got beaten. Her father had hit her small little palms with a ruler, and many hours later her grandmother wrapped her in a shawl and was trying to pacify her. She made her sit in her lap on a rocking chair and she was trying to put Kezia to sleep, and Kezia clung to her grandmother. So Kezia was still not comfortable. She was crying and she said that God should not have made fathers. She hated her father. She was so innocent. She did not know what wrong she had done. She was just preparing a gift for him. She was heartbroken as he did not understand her and said that God should not have made father. Now Kezia's grandmother was trying to pacify her. She gave her a handkerchief to blow her nose in it and go to sleep. She added that by morning Kezia would forget that beating. Kezia tried to justify herself. She said that she was trying to explain to him the reason for tearing the sheets of paper, but he was not ready to listen to her. So again, we will see that the little child was so innocent, she did not realize that her father hit her to teach her a lesson so that she did not touch anything that did not belong to her. Kezia's grandmother had told her to go to sleep and that by morning she would forget the beating that her father gave her. But Kezia never forgot the beating that she had got. Bhul nahi paayi wo kabhi ki usko pitai padi hai. Whenever she saw her father approaching, she would keep her hands behind her back because she felt that maybe he would hit her again, and red color flew into her cheeks. Whenever she saw her father, she got scared and her cheeks got full of red color. Now the writer tells us about Kezia's neighbors. Her neighbors were a family named McDonald's. In all, the McDonald had 5 children, and Kezia would peep at them through a hole in the fence. She would see that the family had a lot of fun, they played a game called tag. Tag is a children's game of catching one another, like we play catch. So all the children along with their father would have a lot of fun. Mr. McDonald would make his little baby Mao sit on his shoulders, and the two little daughters that he had, they would hang on to his coat pocket. So all the children were so much attached to their father. They loved him so much that they would stick to him, and then they would run around the garden, around the flower beds, and they would laugh and laugh and laugh. Kizzy also wanted to have such fun with her father, and she missed it. One day, she saw that the little sons of Mr. McDonald opened the hose on him. They opened the water pipe and tried to make him wet, but Mr. McDonald was not angry with them. He tried to catch them and he was laughing. This was very strange for Kezia, because her father was just opposite of Mr. McDonald. जो वो अपने पापा में देखती थी वो मैकडोनल्ड मिस्टर मैकडोनल्ड में था, और वो चाहती थी कि उसके पापा भी कैसे हों, मिस्टर मैकडोनल्ड जैसे हों. Now Kezia saw Mr. McDonald. She realized that he was quite opposite to her father. She felt that God had made various kinds of father. One day Kezia's mother fell ill, so she was taken to the hospital, and the grandmother also went along with her. Now Kezia was all alone at home with the cook. The name of the cook is Alice. Now Kezia was fine during the day, but at night when the cook put Kezia to bed all alone, Kezia started feeling scared. Kezia asked Alice that if she had a bad dream, what would she do all alone? Kezia explained to Alice that whenever she had nightmares, she would go to her grandmother and she would sleep with her. So she said that she would not stay all alone in the dark because she would be scared. She could hear different kinds of whispering sounds, which made her feel that there was something around her. So Kezia's father was sleeping in the next room, and Alice told Kezia to sleep quietly. She removed Kezia's socks and asked her not to scream. She warned her not to scream and wake her father, but Kezia was helpless. So now this is a nightmare that Kezia had often. She would see a butcher. So this butcher would hold a big knife, a huge butcher's knife and a rope, and he would approach Kezia. He had a dreadful smile on his face, and once Kezia would see him, she would feel that she was unable to move. She was so much scared of him. She was terrified to see this butcher. And in her sleep, Kezia cried out for help. She called for her grandmother. When Kezia woke up, she was shivering and she was trembling, and she saw that her father was standing next to her bed, and he was holding a candle in his hand. So Kezia's father had heard her scream, and he had heard that Kezia was calling for her grandmother, and he had come to help her. उसके पापा वो ड्रीम में जब चिल्ला रही थी तो वो सुन के उसके पास आ गए हैं उसकी हेल्प करने के लिए. Now he asked Kezia what was the matter. Why was she screaming? Kezia was still scared of the nightmares. She said that there was a butcher, he was holding a dreadful knife, and she wanted her grandmother. So here we can see the affection that Kezia's father has for her. He blew the candle off, he lifted her and carried her to his bedroom. Kezia's father lay her in his bed next to him and covered her with a top sheets. Now Kezia felt her father's affection, and so she went close to him. She snuggled herself towards her father and she held his shirt tightly so that she would not feel scared again. And now Kezia had overcome her fear of her father. Now once Kezia was with her father, she was no longer afraid. He asked Kezia to rub her feet against his legs so that they become warm. Now here Kezia realizes her mistake and she had affection towards her father. She felt that her father was a poor man. He worked so hard. He was not so big as she found him to be earlier. Now she felt that her father was a poor man who worked very hard, and so he got so tired that he went off to sleep and did not play with her like Mr. McDonald did with his children. But Kezia felt that her father's heart was also full of love for her. She realizes that she has torn off his important document, the speech that he has written, and all this realization makes her take a deep breath. She realizes that she had been wrong, and that's why her father had beaten her and he had been so strict with her. Although Kezia's father was asleep, he heard her sigh. He heard the sound that Kezia's made, and he asked her what the matter was. Was she again watching a bad dream? Kezia's replied to her father that she had placed her head on her father's heart and she could hear his heartbeat. And she complimented her father that he had a big heart. So Kezia is showing her love for her father, and she had realized that her father also loved her. So here we come to the end of this story. Thank you for listening.